There's been a lot of chatter in the media about Paul Ryan perhaps not living up to his potential as Mitt Romney's running mate. It started with a piece in Politico, spread to the New York Times and the Washington Post, and it came up this morning on Fox News Sunday when the congressman was asked the question.
They are now expressing some frustration that instead of you changing Romney, you've heard this, that they feel that Romney is changing you and you're running a much more cautious campaign.
Mitt Romney has never once asked me to temper anything down. He said, go out there and sell this.
Marie Cox, are the pundits now sort of writing off Paul Romney as a less than successful running mate?
Well, he didn't make, you know, he hasn't put Romney over the top, so therefore he's a less successful running mate, I guess. I mean, I guess we'll all see what we say when Romney or when Ryan gets his own, you know, Fox News reality show after this, or reality show and Fox News show.
Maybe he'll be living in the vice president's mansion.
Maybe so. That would be a great reality show.
But is it realistic, Ramesh Ponnuru, for journalists who have expected a running mate, the guy who's the number two, the guy who takes orders from headquarters, to have totally shaken up and turned the Romney campaign around?
Well, I do think it's unrealistic. You know, when people talk about Ryan being muzzled, they're acting as though the number two should be driving the campaign, and that's just not the way it works. I do think
he could go rogue.
I do think if you picking Ryan implied a strategy of making a stark choice, making an ideological contest, and there hasn't been so much follow-through. So I do think it's a little puzzling as to what Romney's campaign strategy has been over the last 2 months, and it does seem to be sort of veering around a fair amount.
Chrystia Freeland, there was a lot of talk in the press when Ryan was picked. It was kind of a surprise pick that this was a very bold selection of Mitt Romney's part to make, as Ramesh just said, make the campaign about big issues, particularly Medicare, and energize the base. But now the media consensus, right or wrong, seems to be that none of that happened, and that perhaps it was not. In fact, maybe it was a pick that has hurt the ticket.
So I totally agree with Ramesh here. I think that the Ryan pick actually represented the Romney campaign being a little bit spooked, partly spooked by people like us, the sort of punditocracy, partly spooked by the conservative base.
I didn't know we had that much power.
Well, we seem to, because, you know, I think up to that point, Romney was running a very disciplined campaign whose focus was pragmatism and managerial excellence. And the Romney pick said, actually, we are ideologues as well. And I think what we're seeing now is the Romney campaign saying, no, no, we're not. We're about managerial excellence and pragmatism. And that's why I think you're seeing the back and forth. And I think, in fact, the managerial excellence and pragmatism is the only place for Romney to be, because that is what is authentic about him. And I think he's going to win or lose on that battlefield. And if he deviates from it, I think that weakens him, as we're seeing now with sort of the iffiness around Ryan.
National Review reporting that Ryan has recently reached out to some conservative commentators like George Will and Larry Kudlow and Paul Jugot, who he has relationships with these people. Well, it circles back to our conversation about media bias, which is if the Romney campaign is zigging and zagging in terms of its strategy, picks Ryan's going to go bold and it's not so bold, then it's not exactly a case of bias on the part of journalists to point this out.
I don't disagree with that. I do think that in addition to the sort of objective things that one would cover negatively or skeptically about the Romney campaign, that there's something in addition. Look, the first national campaign I covered was the Bob Dole campaign. Totally hopeless campaign. And yet there was less of a media drumbeat saying that it's all over in mid-September than there was for the Romney-Ryan campaign this year.
Final thought.
Oh, I was just saying that I think Chrystia's right. I think the Romney campaign was spooked. I think that one, this is a sign of a crumbling campaign, though, is when you get spooked, when you start paying attention, not to necessarily your own press, but to what's going on in the press more than what's going on with the voters. Sometimes I feel like the Romney campaign is trying to win the press over, almost, or trying to get that positive coverage, and they're never going to do that for many of the reasons that...
Don't listen to the geniuses in the media. We have a habit of keep changing our minds. Chrystia Freeland in New York, Ramesh Ponnuru, Anna Marie Cox here in Washington. Thanks very much for stopping by.